Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, everybody. This is Dr. H.P. Ravindra, principal of PES College of Engineering, Mandya. In fact, today we are under the Department of our Physical Education and Sports. We are organizing a webinar on the topic Technology in Sports and its Future. I welcome all the three experts and also all the participants who have attending this webinar. First of all, I welcome Dr. Kishore Kumar CK, Director of Physical Education, Mangalore University, who will be giving a preamble regarding this topic. Just to give a brief introduction of Dr. Kishore Kumar CK, with an experience of 30 years, sir was also an in-charge Vice-Chancellor of Mangalore University and a former syndicate member, and he has held various posts, membership, and he is the man behind creating a new instrumental shape in Mangalore University for providing lot of facilities for the students. He has organized a lot of events, especially in the field of All India Uni inter-university levels, and he has established an international standards gymnasium, sports research laboratory, and many others in the Mangalore University. I welcome you, sir, and also I congratulate you for awarded by the Mangalore University as a best teacher. Sir, I welcome you for this webinar, which is organized from the Department of Physical Education and Sports of our college, who will be giving address. And two more speakers who is going to join along with Dr. Kishore Kumar are Mr. Ankit Nagori. Ankit Nagori is a graduate from IIT Guwahati, and he is the gentleman who has started his own fitness brand called as Q.Fit. He has worked in Flipkart for many years, and now he has started his own brand, fitness brand, which is called as Q.Fit. Sir, I welcome you for this webinar. The other gentleman who is going to address the gathering is Mr. Darshan, who is a graduate from Nitya College, Karkala, with an experience of 3 years in Infosys. Now he is towards sports management and fortunate enough to work some of the prestigious events like London Olympics, Davis Cup, IPL. He is also the founder of Simply Sports Foundation. On behalf of myself and Mr. Anand Padmanabha, Director of Physical Education, and all with my colleagues, I welcome all the three speakers and also the participants who have registered for this webinar. Enjoy the webinar. Thank you.
I thank our beloved principal, dynamic, inspiring, and beloved respected principal, Dr. H.P. Ravindra, convener of this webinar, to welcome you all. Thank you. So, before we start today's session, dear participants, please note, if you are having any queries related to this topic, feel free to post it in the chat box. Question and answer session planned by the end of this webinar. Now I request our beloved today's honorable guest and keynote speaker, my ideologist, Dr. Kishore Kumar CK, Director of Physical Education and Sports, to deliver keynote address. Over to you, sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir. How are you, sir?
Yeah, me. Okay. Am I audible?
Yeah. Yes, sir, you're audible.
Visible.
Thank you. So, hello to everyone. And very good afternoon to all the participants of this webinar. Myself, Kishore Kumar CK, Director of Physical Education, Mangalore University, Karnataka. Here I am to talk about technology in sports and its future. Before that, I would like to render my humble thanks to a young, energetic and lover of sports, Sri K.S. Vijayanand, President of P.S. Mandya, and a fine administrator and very dynamic principal of the college, Dr. H.V. Ravindra, Mr. Ananta Padmanabha, Director of Physical Education and Organizing Secretary of this webinar, and members of the staff for giving me a wonderful opportunity to share my experience with my professional friends and to give some ideas on technology in sports. I also take this opportunity to wish other two resource persons, Mr. Ankit and Mr. Darshan, since they are from engineering background, surely they will give more inputs on technology and sports and its future. And we all know that PES Engineering College of Mandya is known for quality education and achievement in sports. Long back, more than 10 years back, I got the opportunity to do umpiring in one of the state match held at PS campus cricket ground. That time I had seen the other sports facilities available like
Sir Kishore Kumar, sir.
It's muted, yeah.
Sir, unmute yourself, sir. Unmute. Yeah, thank you.
Start from the beginning or?
Start.
Hello?
Yeah, no.
Okay. Hello?
Can you proceed, sir. No problem. You can continue, sir.
Okay. Thank you. As I said, it's very nice to see all those facilities in an education institution. Really, I hats off to PS management. And you have very aptly selected subjects for the webinar. I think after hearing the importance of technology in sports, at least a few engineering students will opt to do research in technology, which would enhance the performance of sports persons, because everything is dependent on the technology at the present in the sports, and we are all depend on the science. Dear friends, we all know the basic concept of life, so it's no science, no life. That is the basic concept. It is very much applicable to the field of sports. Sports, once considered leisure time activity, has now turned into a commercial activity. It's not a leisure time activity at present. More specifically, sports has turned into a rich industry. Now we have reached to a stage, no science, no sports industry. So that is the present condition. And this was made possible because of the incorporation of new technology in sports. Sports is growing day by day, and newer innovations are taking place in the field of sports. Technology has really changed the sports, and the situation in the sports has been changed because of this new technologies. And it is difficult to imagine at present the modern sports without technologies. Everywhere this technology is applied in the sports. And indeed, the invasion of technology has, as I said, profoundly changed the landscape of sport and exercise science. Today's webinar is aimed at exploring the technology in sports and its future. I think most of the participants being from the Department of Physical Education and Sports, I personally suggest that we all should be aware of the modern technologies in sports and how best we could incorporate technology in our daily sports activities, especially while imparting training to sports persons. Since the days of industrial, a revolution, technology has been utilized in sports, and as a result of the concept of commercialization, has ventured into, ventured into sports. Sports, this have grown into a big industry today. It's totally commercialized and it is a big, very big industry today. A lot of investors are competing to invest in the sports field. Huge money is flowing to sports industry and sports event management and to conduct different national, international sports programs. This question may surely arise in our mind. How did sports grow as an industry? What is the secret of a huge influx of money to sports? The simplest answer to all this question is science and technology in sports. Science and technology in sports. This technology has been used in manufacturing sports equipment, clothing, some wearable equipments, facilities, sports gadgets, media broadcasting and communications, research in the field of sports, in the field of physical education, and in the area of performance, etc. This technology is increasingly playing a leading role in the development of sport and enhancing performance in all aspects of sports by giving effective training, stimulations, management, and tracking of athletes, accuracy of results, enhanced spectator viewing, and developing of performance and preventing of injuries, amongst many more functions we can observe, we can see at present. And this technology is changing the face of modern sports, as I said. Not only the sports participation, it also changed the face of psychology of the participants, physiological aspects, biomechanical aspects, training aspects, coaching aspects, etc. The state of art of these technologies, used to improve the performance in sports, as we observed in the badminton rackets, cricket bats, swimming costumes or related to the swimming, using of synthetic surfaces for different events, athletics, badminton, volleyball, football, the synthetic surfaces were used, and the replay techniques in officiating in football, tennis, badminton, like that, and the photo finish equipments, skill analysis technologies, technologies for the biomechanical analysis, technologies for physiological analysis of sports persons, facilities, and many more that we are seeing at present in the field of sports. Moreover, this technology is used in the production of nutritional foods suiting a specific sport, specific sports persons or a specific event, and also in the production of medicines to treat the sports injuries. Now let us look into the benefits of technology in sports. First of all, technology is used in manufacture of sports apparels, which help in boosting performance of the sports person. About a century back, sports persons used to wear any type of dress and take part in sports competitions. Women, especially in India, used to wear Bermuda and loose t-shirts or tops and take part in different events. One was the social stigma to wear compressed dresses, and other was not having proper awareness of knowing the benefit of wearing the compressed garments, which are very popular now. Milkha Singh, the great athlete of India, had run in a barefoot once. And he was very close to medal also. And over the years, this science and technology was applied in designing the dresses, suiting different games and also footwears, so as to enhance the performance of the players. Now, each game and the sports has its own apparels. Take, for example, cricket or badminton or swimming, including the footwear. This has indeed reduced many types of injuries. That is the advantage of this new sports technology. And every sportsman has been properly guided about this using of new technologies for the training or for the practice or for the participation. Trainers, they guided these sports persons and about the outfits that has to be worn for the specific sports and games. Here, the compression garments like those produced by leading sports companies have a very elastic quality due to the high, lycra contents. That is a synthetic fabric. So that is very useful and very beneficial for the sports persons to perform. The material fits tightly to the skin, and the squeezing of muscles without causing discomfort. So that is the advantage of that cloth. And a comfortable athlete is more likely, or he perform better. He should be very comfort while participating or during the competition time. Now, a cautious sports person will take certain steps to wear properly fitted apparel, specific for purpose. So that development we can see in the field of sports at present. Secondly, technology is applied in the production of sports gadgets. We can see a good helmet for a batsman will very helpful at present. I was just observing, watching India-Australia match. I've seen the helmets they were using. Surely that is very comfortable at present. Earlier, we used to wear the helmet, which is very uncomfortable, and that itself is a burden for the player. Now, the helmets are very comfortable. Helmets are available. So, the quality gadgets are produced, and which is very comfortable and very balanced for the player to perform. And we can also see the reflectors in sports attire that will make visible in low light conditions also. And in the gyms, we are seeing the gloves used by the performers. And even in the women's section, say the top they are using that made of a breathable material that will allow and access heat to heat. And it is useful to remove or to come out from such conditions, like from the hot weather. And the different the shoes, the correctly fitted shoes will help to prevent the blisters and cramps and other type of injuries the legs of the foot of the players. And orthotic inserts that will really support the runners and for the jumpers in athletic events. And this technology helps us better understand of the games. With so many sports and their intricate rules, no wonder we need a pointer or two here and there. This technology has done a great job at making it easier to understand what is going on in a game by highlighting the most important things going on. One way this has been done is through sports channels. Here, a revolutionary way of showing the intricacies of the game. So it is possible at present. And it shows which players scored, why and who could have prevented it. This way, we are never lost as a sports fan. And it gives us something to look for the next time we run on the game. As I said, I was watching India-Australia match, the live telecast. So here, I observed a lot of changes. Not a lot of development I have observed in the telecasting of the match and the picturizing of the situations. These are all the changes because of advanced technology in the field of sports. And this technology has helped in the providing information to the sports persons. This is another advantage in the field of sports. Now, anyone with a smartphone can download applications that make following sports as easy as receiving these text messages. And this sports channels, mobiles, and other websites have made it very simple to follow the scores and read analysis in any way so that we can do it. And because of this, it has made even the most casual sports fan into a technology junk. Further, this technology has made possible to watch more games. Now, the sports TV channels, Hotstar, and other channels are all ways for the biggest sports fans, no matter where they live, to catch every game. The question is it healthy to watch every game there is? Maybe, may not. But at least we have the option at present. Earlier, we didn't have this type of options. And we can see the instant replies. These instant replies are available due to technology. A reply could be most important. It is most important a technological advancement, as I observed in sports. Now, it is up to each individual sports to do the right thing and adopt the practice in order to ensure the accuracy. Reply has now become an important part of the higher level matches also. Both athletes, sports persons, and the fans want the game to be fair. We are expecting that. We don't want to see the match which is already fixed. Match should be very fair. and the officiating should be very, very fair. Such matches everybody likes to see and like to see, and they will really enjoy it. And at present, you know, any mistakes in the officiating that can be corrected. So correcting mistakes is the only the way to ensure that the game gets played the right way, and the man or the woman who deserve to win actually does. Take for example Hawkeye technology. This Hawkeye technology helps to take the error-free decision in cricket, lawn tennis, football, badminton, baseball, like that. So, see, this technology has reduced the criticism of the players and the spectators about the decision of the match ref. And I said, these are all the advantages. And this advancement in technology is also observed among the disabled, I mean, special students, sports, whatever, or disabled athletes. There, we can see a lot of technologies used for the better participation of the disabled students or a disabled person. And as I said, this technology plays an important role in modern sport, with it being a necessary part of some parts and used the others to improve the performance. So here, making changes to a event or in the sport with the inclusion of new technologies has often caused controversy. This also we have to note. Some of the controversies are absurd because of advanced technologies. But one criticism of the use of technology is that it can slow down the speed of the game. That we have observed in Kabaddi and some other events, it will slow down the game. But on the other hand, for many people, it makes watching it more enjoyable to see the correct decisions being made. If a new technology is available and shown to be accurate, then it should be used so that the correct decision can be made. It is only fair to the players and to the teams that the right decisions are made. That is very important in the sports, and it will help to keep the spirit of the sports or the game. So these are all the different changes or advancement we are observing in the field of sports. With this brief note about the use of technology in sports, I can conclude saying sports technologies are man-made means developed to reach human interests or goals or relating to a particular sport. And it is a technical means by which a sports person attempt to improve their training and competitive surroundings in order to enhance their overall performance. And it is the knowledge and application of using specialized equipment and the latest modern technologies to perform tasks more efficiently. Therefore, the coaches, the trainers, the athletes must be aware of the sports technology and make wise choices about how it affects or the affects their performance. I hope this webinar will serve the purpose for which it has been organized. Once again, I thank the organizers for the opportunity given to me. And be safe and take care of your health. And think of more research in the field of technology, particularly the engineers. This webinar has been organized in the engineering college. So at least engineering students, they will think of developing some technologies for the enhancement of the performance of the sports persons. So once again, I thank for the opportunity, and my special thanks to Mr. Ananta Padmanabha, the director of physical education, for giving me an opportunity to speak to give keynote address in this webinar. Thank you one and all.
Thank you very much, sir, for your valuable talk, and I really hope all the participants will be benefited with your words. Yes, sir. Our college and the Department of Physical Education and Sports, PIC Mandya, would like to be connected with you in future for the guidance to achieve betterment of sports. Thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome.
Now, I request our renowned speaker, Ankit Nagori, to deliver his speech on today's topic. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you are able to hear me well. So me and Darshan, you know, will take you all through some of the thoughts. Some of the thoughts have been covered by sir, so we will not repeat that, but whatever other points are there, we will definitely talk about that. Like the topic says, technology in sports and its future. We all have experienced in the last, you know, few years that the technology has created a lot of impact across many, many sectors. Imagine 10 years back, there was no smartphone, there was no Ola, Swiggy, Flipkart, and just 10 years of technology work, look at what has been created. And that's what my background is. I spent a lot of time working in Flipkart in the early years of Flipkart, and now in the last few years was working on CureFit. CureFit is a platform which helps people stay healthy using technology, fitness, mental wellness, nutrition, etc. At the same time, while they were doing CureFit, I realized that there's an opportunity to create something in the world of sports. And that's what Simply Sport is. I'll quickly take you through what Simply Sport is, an organization which me and Darshan have started. Simply Sport Foundation is an NGO which is focused on three areas: policy research, grassroots development, and technology in sports. In policy research, basically, we are trying to work with schools, colleges, federations, clubs to figure out how sports can be improved, what can be created as a framework, what can be created as a curriculum. How can we work with the government to make sure certain things can be improved about certain sports? Some rules can be brought in, some rules can be eased. So we've just started work there. Grassroots development, promoting sports in rural areas amongst underprivileged people. Sports has a lot of monetary needs also. It requires equipment, it requires coaching. And unfortunately, people who come from the underprivileged background may or may not have access to that. But a lot of good sports people, would be in that segment. So how can we discover, identify those people and bring them to the forefront? Then comes technology in sports. This is a very, very important focus area for us, and hence very excited to talk about what Simply Sport, can do and can contribute in this area. So we feel that sports requires fitness, performance, nutrition, mental wellness. It requires all these four things, and coaching, of course, all these five things. For any sports person to be able to put this together by themselves, to be able to, make it happen by themselves, is very tough. It requires one single app. It requires one single tracking. And that's what we feel should be created. And we will continue to work with companies, schools, colleges, athletes to create that technology over the next couple of years and find a way to distribute it across the country. But today, what we will talk about is more about what is already there, what are the technologies already available, and then we'll go deep into each of these. So if you can move to the next slide, Darshan, we'll quickly talk about these, and you can take the audience through the deeper answer. So this is where technology is in sports. Interestingly, 15 years back, none of this was there. But now, so much work has happened and so much is happening. First one, improving the viewing experience. How to make the viewing experience of watching matches better. Second is improving analytics and how can one look at the past performance and improve the future performance. Third is training, support, and tracking, something which I just spoke of. How can we create apps which can give full content, full guidance to athletes? Talent scouting. India has 40 crore people who are below the age of 20. So many of them would be, you know, playing sports. How do we identify people who are good at it? Only technology can do that. Then, of course, there are, you know, fantasy leagues, e-games, a lot of content work happening on the fan side. So a lot of progress has been made. The interesting thing about technology is that anyone can create it, anyone can use it, but the overall benefit of the ecosystem is huge. So many apps, you know, ease the life for everyone. And especially in the last 8-9 months of the lockdown, we all have realized how important technology is. With the help of technology, we're able to live our lives in a very comfortable way, even during lockdown. Else imagine what could have been. So with this note, I will get Darshan to, you know, take you all through the slides, and I will keep chipping in wherever we need to. And of course, we'll be happy to take questions. So Darshan, please.
Yeah, thank you. Yes, so as Ankit mentioned about, you know, the various adaptations of technology in sports where we use on a regular basis. So these are some of the areas which will be taking you, everyone through, you know, where technology will be absolutely used. So to start with, see the live technology. So improving viewing and on-screen experience. You might already have experienced, Kishore sir also spoke about the, some technologies that are, you know, used in cricket and other sports. One of the technologies is Hawkeye, that I'm sure you watched it in football and cricket and tennis as well. So it's a ball tracking technology where cameras are used, multiple cameras are used across to see as ball touch the, you know, has crossed the line or has it touched the bat. So this will help the umpires and the sport actors to make the, you know, right decisions. Sneakometer in cricket, again, it checks whether, you know, there's a hot spot on the bat, ball has touched the bat. And this will help you calculate, you know, the frequency, distortions, wavelength of the sounds to calculate that, and it gives you the right decision. Hotspot again is another, everyone knows about, that's being used in cricket. Let's move to the next technology. The VAR in football is a very famous one that recently launched last year, a couple of years by FIFA. Now it's being used worldwide in most of the top leagues in football, where decisions such as goals, red cards, penalties, and an entity which have a lot of impact on the game is always checked. If there is, that, you know, there is a mistake made, then he always goes back and checks using video technology. Goal and technology football to check if goal has crossed the line. It uses, again, high-speed cameras which are kept around the ground, which focus on the ball if see if it has crossed the if it has crossed the line or not. Some of the performance improvement analytics, which are softwares that are being used at ELO score. So we are giving a few examples here. So ELO score is one that is it's a method for calculating relative skill levels of players in games, especially in chess. So you can see where, in terms of their performance, how they are ranked, where they need to, you know, expected, how they're being performed over the last couple of games that they've been playing. Sabermetrics, it uses a statistical analysis to analyze baseball records and make determinations about player performance. I'm sure most of them who are in this webinar might have was the Moneyball movie, where this skill was used to see track a player's performance, where they're hitting the ball. And based on this player's performance and player's tracking data, they were able to scout for players that they fit into the particular team. And, you know, this helps in, you know, selecting players which suit the particular teams. Right. Now, moving to hardwares, a lot of hardwares have been come up in the last couple of years. Picaton, which is an Indian-based, which Anil Kumble has developed in association with Microsoft. It enables IoT-enabled bats. You know, they're kept in the bats, and this will record key life, key parameters, performance from players. And if you have a smartphone or an iPad, it will send back the data. So with this, you can track your performance. How do you need to improve your performance in terms of your bat shot selection, and areas of, you know, where you need to improve statistically. Adidas MI Coach has been there for a long time now. They have moved to put, they have used in football a smart chip, like a sensor that detects, you know, the movement of the ball in terms of the spin, speed, strike, and the slide path. This, basically, it again helps you with a lot of data that can be sent back to the smartphone, and you can sit back, coaches can analyze it, This helps the coaches and associations in improving the performance. Wilson X Connector is another sports court. It's based for used in basketball. That has a similar functionality as Adidas MI Coach sensor. A couple of AI tracking tools that are being used, especially in running and cycling. Strava is a very famous app that is used by most of the runners and cyclists across the globe. Nowadays, even like you heard of Delhi Half Delhi Marathon, you can do it if you're in Bangalore. Even if you're in a small town, you can do it from your home itself. All you need to do is log in. They will give you a login chip, and you can run certain miles, the number of miles, and then record back the data. And then allows logging in nutrition. So it also nutrition aspects comes into picture here. So suppose depending on your nature of training, it'll help you with what kind of nutrition needs to be consumed and where you need intervention need to be happened. PureFit, I'm sure most of them know about it now. Ankit is a co-founder of PureFit. It's an all-in-one, one-stop place for all nutrition, your mental fitness, mental wellness, fitness, and workout platform. We also now have digital workout where people can work out from home. They don't have to visit center if they don't feel safe. So you have access to all these places in one place. You also can book a nutrition. You can also order nutrition in the app itself. Also, you can take a live appointment with doctors as well. Great. Talent scouting. And these couple of them apps that have been now popping up are helping. You know, help people upload their data. So earlier, what happened? If you see cricket or any other sport, people didn't have much access to uploading the data. So even if you have to scout for a player, it has to be only the top players, only the professional players' record you would want. But now, even a regular normal cricketer or normal club level cricketer or a normal player, he can upload his data on apps like Cricket Hero that have come up. And if you can go check his record, see how his performance is, how much he has scored in the last game. So this can help, you know, teams, clubs, and, you know, even coaches find right players. And I'll help identify some youngsters who earlier couldn't have been found. So this is like a boon, you know, for a lot of these youngsters who are now able to, keep themselves up to date with technology and upload their data. Well, fantasy sports and leagues, a lot of impetus now has come on these games, Dream 11. A lot of, if you see, more than millions of people are now availing this platform. As soon as match starts, people logging in to, you know, create their own fantasy team. This is a mind skill game. Again, you need to, you know, be smart enough to, you should know the background statistics. You should know a lot of, we should be aware of a lot of statistics about the sports to play. And people are now, you know, hooking on to it. This is a very easy game. So you just have to create teams and then wait for how the players perform. And then based on that, you can earn, you can win some, you know, prizes and earn money. PUBG, I'm sure most of the know it's been banned now, but still it was a sensation a couple of months back. Some new games have come up to channel that blockage. Online poker is it's a skill, mind skill based game. It was actually a banned game now, but now it's been made legal in India. So people are now playing a lot of online poker sites have come up. People are now again taking on poker as one of the games. Great. Moving to fan insights and engagement. What is fan insights? So basically, it's about capturing fans' information. So top clubs around the world, even if you say example of Manchester United, they are supposed to be the top, one of the top clubs in the world. So how they got this was because of their fan engagement across the globe. So they were able to analyze the spending habits. They were able to analyze people's demography. They were able to, engage with the fans across, and they were able to expand into new markets. They were able to evaluate the media rights, sponsorship value of the club. Hence, their value of Manchester United went up. So the fan insights will help clubs basically or associations analyze how fans interact with their teams and where they need to be intervened. So coming to fan engagement, this is two aspects here. We have fan engagement, it's called how the teams or the clubs interact with the fans. Earlier, it used to be very simple. You go to the stadium, buy ticket, and then enter the stadium. But now you have in-stadia engagement where they provide you Wi-Fi access. There is smart stadiums where you don't need a ticket. You just log in at your phone. You come there, there's smart parking available. there are seats assigned for you. You can even book food inside the stadium where it comes to your stand itself where you're seated. Home, if not everyone can go to stadium, but there now clubs have come up with, and teams have come up with live game interactions where there's virtual reality where people can wear devices and see what's going on inside the dressing room. They can interact live with the players on the phone. A lot of engagements being done technology. I'll also talk about wearable devices. Kishore sir was stressing on how these wearable devices are making waves in the sports. Wearable devices mostly come in the form of monitors, clothing, and sensors. These are the devices that help the players, teams, coaches, associations collect massive amount of data, especially about athletes, heart rate, his glucose level, how his breathing is, his fatigue, where is he more injury prone, and help athletes in improving their performance on a day-to-day basis. This can, as I said, it can be monitored and improve performance. One of the examples is the famous one is Catapult. I'm sure most of you have watched players before the matches wearing Catapult jersey, which is a half-slit one. It has sensors within that. It has a more GPS tracking sensor, which provides every aspect of players' motion and monitors their every aspect of their body movements. SmartLife is again a textile-based smart sensor that is integrated into cutting-edge smart garments. So here's the sensor captures every aspect of body, the real time, it captures in real time, the body and transfers signals back to the device, it could be a smartphone or an iPad for analysis. Again, this helps coaches and associations in, the monitoring their data. Well, I'll also ask, I think most of the technology we spoke about has been a boon for the industry. Sports, again, if you see compared to the last 10 years, has taken big strides in where it has been, or where we are today. But there are again a lot of challenges that comes with technology in sports. I'll run to for each for particular like example for athletes. Not every technology is coming with it comes with a cost. Availability and cost is an issue. So not every athlete gets a chance to use this technology. Basically, you see good countries, top countries, developed countries use this technology, and only athletes who are pro athletes get a chance to use it. At least the lower level are still void of these technologies. With technology, athletes are put under more pressure that they have to be up to date with the technology. Otherwise, their performance goes below par. Again, because a lot of data is being used here, personal data especially. So players' personal data is being uploaded into apps and other places. So there could be chance of breaches of data that can be play some vital role in the failure of technology. For officials, it slows down the game. You might have seen in football nowadays or cricket, there's always a lot of break in between players celebrate and then goal is not awarded. And then it again goes back to, the game becoming slower and slower. A big challenge is to have the technology in all level of competitions. We only see in the top level of the competitions. We don't see it in, grassroots or in the middle sections. For spectators and broadcasters, there is a big increase in technology because of the cost incurred. Obviously, the cost of viewership goes high. To buy a ticket, tickets might be more costlier now. Also, live channel, subscribing to a live channel might be a little more costly because of the technology they use, they incur in spending in buying technology. Also, it reduces atmosphere live events. You might have seen people more hooked onto their phones. They might be not what's happening on the ground. They might be not looking at what's happening on the ground. For sport in general, accuracy of technology is, although it is in trial, it's more about improving the technology on a day-to-day basis, but there are always questions on the accuracy of how technology is being effectively used. Generally, again, the cost of using technology goes higher and higher. As I said, in the goal line technology, we see earlier we used to have only one camera. But to use a goal line technology, you need seven cameras to turn to high speed cameras to be located, which directly is a cost factor that is involved there. Great. Any questions, guys, at this stage? Again, please bounce it across to me or Ankit. We are here. We'll be happy to take some questions on the technology.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for your experience and elaborating of this session of this on this topic. Now it is a question and answer section. I have got a few questions, sir, to the Ankit and Darshan. Ankit, question from Dr. Manoj from NITK, sports officer. How can India leverage on technology for sports?
Sure. So I think it's a broad question, but I'll still try and answer it, you know, on what are the focus areas which we should be working on. See, all the technologies that Darshan just spoke of, they're all for very pro or semi-pro athletes. It's for professionals and semi-professional athletes. What we should, in our daily lives, at least start looking at is to start using tracking apps, whether it is tracking for your personal best scores or your training or your nutrition, fitness. I think that's a great start. And a lot of low-cost fitness bands are available now, which can integrate with the apps on the phone. And it can be a great start. The other important area which can start slowly is the smart equipment. It could be a smart bag, it could be a smart, it will be available by using those individually. Some academies, some schools, some colleges can buy it. I'm sure this technology will become very cheap over time and they'll be able to do it.
One more question to Ankit Nagori from Ravi, physical director of B.Ed. College, Shankare Gowda B.Ed. College, Mandya. He's asking regarding experience with CureFit.
Sure. Yeah, so the journey has been very, very interesting. When we started CureFit, we realized that the overall health as a category is extremely fragmented. If someone wants to stay healthy, they have to go to gym, they have to eat healthy food, they have to do yoga, meditate, sleep on time. And just doing all of these things every day, every time is super difficult. It's not something, which can be done easily every single day. So to make sure, people are able to track all of these, are able to fulfill all of these, we launched this app called CureFit, which has all these verticals which I spoke of. And now a lot of digital solutions are also there. So over the last 4 years, millions of people have tried the product. The feedback has been very good. And clearly, a lot of sports athletes can also benefit by using CureFit, if at all. So, yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir, for explanation.
Yes.
And no more question. I think all the viewers are satisfied with the presentation. Thank you very much, sir. Now, so my dear friends, today we have witnessed a wonderful webinar on technology in sports and its future. An event like this cannot overnight. The wheel started rolling a week ago, PSC Mandya, with a team of very motivated mentors and experts who knows the job very well, has achieved it. It's my privilege to present the word of thanks for this special webinar. First and foremost, my heartily thank to our president, Mr. Vijay Anand, and other stakeholders of PET Register Mandya, who have been the backbone of PSC Mandya and always giving prominence to sports. On behalf of the team, I sincerely thanks our respected principal, Dr. H.V. Ravindra, who is never say die attitude, always infuse great vigor, strength and energy in all of us and always motivate us to work selflessly to the welfare of everyone. Thank you, sir. This event was graced by the presence of great and renowned speakers. I deemed great with great honor and privilege to thank Dr. Kishore Kumar CK, Director of Physical Education, Mangalore University, and Mr. Ankit Nagoria, co-founder of CureFit, and Mr. Darshan NK, sports management background, for their wonderful talk on today's topic. I would also thank our TechEP coordinator, Dr. B. Dinesh Prabhu, Dr. Vinay Sir, HOD, ISE, and Dr. B.S. Shukumar Sir, Professor, Department of IT, and Mr. Ullas P., Department of ECE, and Dr. Umesh Dear, Deputy Dean, Academic, for their continuous support and guidance throughout this webinar. Thank you, sir. I thank all my dear colleagues, friends, technical staff, and physical education professionals of PET groups of institution for their wonderful contribution and hard work to make this event to least sounding and successful. Last but not least, I'd like to thank distinguished participants, attendees, and our valuable viewers present here, putting your extra effort during your busy time. So I thank you all, dear viewers. Last but not least, I thank once again all of you for present here. Dear viewers, feedback will be shared through mail and WhatsApp group. Kindly make time to fill it. Certificate will be issued considering both your attendance and your feedback. Thank you, one and all, sir.
Anand, sorry to stop you. Just a second. I would like to, forgot to announce a small kind of contest for the students who are participated in this.
Okay, sir. Proceed.
The Foundation would like to, announce a competition, like a contest. This is about creating an app. Now, since most of them are from engineering background, we would like to throw up an like a contest where they can anyone who's interested can develop an app for sports person where they can log their daily practice and where people can post their scores, upload their footage, and they can be able to help others. So this can be this app. Basically, we want to use it for talent scouting purpose. So we'll announce a prize money as well for the winners. So details will be announced. We will talk to PES and PES College will announce the details on this contest.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for all once again. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir.